الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت ذي العزة والجبروت، الحمد لله ذي الفضل والكرم ذي القدرة والنعم، الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام، عزيز لا يضام، قهار لا يرام، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. For you believe, fear Allah as He should be feared and die not except on the state of Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, grant us this great gift to die in the state of Islam. Allahumma amin. Allahumma barik lana fi Ramadan. Waj'alna min alladhina yasumunahu wa yuqimunahu imanan wa ihtisab. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower us with a great blessing in this blessed month and make us from those who fasted and pray and make the qiyam imanan with full and complete faith wa ihtisaban seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this great occasion of Ramadan, it is maybe befitting to remind ourselves the great mission of a believer and what is required from him in this great month. A month that he turned in the Ummah to be a month of food, a month of filling the bellies and entertain the eyes with what displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did make this month a month for the believer to reflect, to ponder, to go back to the Book of Allah, the source of light and life, and to renew the hope of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran a beautiful ayat that it requires a lot of complete contemplation and reflection. In one of the ayat in Surah Al-Jathiyah, as in many other ayat, look like the same ayat, الله الذي سخر لكم ما في الله الذي سخر لكم البحر لتجري الفلك فيه بأمره ولتبتغوا من فضله ولعلكم تشكرون وسخر لكم ما في السماوات وما في الأرض جميعا منه إن في ذلك لآيات لقوم يتفكرون. Allah makes observant to you the sea for the boat to sail in it and for you to seek from His bounty subhanahu wa ta'ala that you may be grateful. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes observant to you. He subjected whatever in the heaven and the earth to you. Minhu, just granted from Him, special gift for you. And indeed in these are signs of people of understanding. And one of the scholars, Yahya ibn Mu'adh, he was reflecting on such an ayat, he's saying, it's like the human being, like a pearl, but you don't know that you are a pearl, being ignored, like a pearl in a dumpster doesn't know someone the value of this pearl. And he's saying, as it's been mentioned in the hadith, who is the target in this whole universe? It's you. It's not the money, it's not the accumulation, it's not the life of the system, it's you. Can you imagine when you think of this air, that the sun that it rises is serving you? The moon, when it sets and rises, is serving you. The day and the night is serving you. The food that Allah is bringing up out from the earth is serving you. And you are supposed to serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a reflection for us in Ramadan, to revive the mission that we are created for, to revive the dignity that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to the believer, to revive the honor and the mission and the call that someone he needs to live for, to renew the oath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to refresh the light in his iman, to refresh and revive the soul of the iman. That is Ramadan what is for. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he made all this, imagine he made everything subservient to you. Now, the mission is the ubudiyyah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As all of us, we know Allah created us to worship him. But someone will ask and should ask what is the meaning of the worship, because it does have different perspective, does have different dimension in following the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you know, it's amazingly, I will give you the equation, but then we reflect on it. Do you know that the state of the universe outside, the corruption and you see in the, and the mischief you see in the land and the seas, it is a reflection of the heart of the people? It is a reflection, the state of the universe around us is the reflection of every heart we have here on the planet Earth. How is that? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made, like we have the air to breathe with. Without air we cannot live. What is the air that the universe, that the creation is breathing, that Allah makes observant to us? It is the rightest action. It is the rightest action. Therefore, the mission of the believer, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala, وَلَا تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ بَعْدَ إِصْلَاحِهَا. He created you this earth in perfect order. He created this earth in perfection to provide for you all what you need by the will of Allah. Therefore, do not spread mischief in it. So the message and the mission of the believer, how to preserve reform, how to preserve the order in the earth, what we call al-aslah. Therefore, Risalatul Mu'min, the message of the believer, is to preserve al-aslah in the earth because of the well-being of the universe. This is how Allah dignified human being, and specifically the believer, to carry this great message. Do not think that you are so little. Do not think that you're gonna be just a consumer and you will be only appreciated based on the money that you spend in the market. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored you to carry this great mission, which is mission of al-Aslah. The mission, how to protect the whole universe. And how you will protect it? With a very simple thing. As I said, what you see outside is the reflection of the heart. What we see outside is the reflection of the heart. Why? Because the heart is the engine of the action. And the action will do good or bad. Therefore, the righteousness done in this universe, it comes from one source, which is the pure Iman, which is the faith. And the opposite of that will be ungratefulness, denial, and kufr. Therefore, the origin of all corruption, the origin of all destruction, the origin of all the mischief is the kufr. And in the other side, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the Iman, the faith, is the origin and the source of every good thing. That's why the believer, when he think of that, it's like his heart. The more you have Iman in it, the more you'll be yourself blessed. How can be someone blessed? Blessed and spreading blessing. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Isa when he was talking in the cradle, he said, alayhi salam, qala wa ja'alani mubarakan haythu ma kuntu. He made you to be a blessed one wherever I will be. It is only specific and special for Isa, not but for everyone who's carrying the true, sincere Iman in his heart. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith al-Hasan, as narrated by Tirmidhi, Ummati kal-ghayth, Ummati kal-ghayth, my Ummah is like the rain. لا يدرى أو لا يدري أخير أولها الأخير. You don't know which the best among this, my Ummah, the first or the last. We know the first generation are the best. But we say, is that the good in this Ummah, as long as they preserving the Iman and acting upon this great message of al-Aslah. You see, like they are resembling each other. Everyone is working from the beginning of the Ummah to the end of the Ummah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, مَثَلُ مَا بَعَثَنِي اللَّهُ بِهِ مِنَ الْهُدَى وَالْعِلْمِ كَمَثَلِ الْغَيْثِ. The example or the parable that what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent you with guidance and knowledge is like the rain. The rain which is life. قال أصاب أرضا فمنها لقية قبيلة الماء فأنبتت الملأ العشب والكلاء الكثير. Some of these lands, and this is the land when we're talking about the parable of the heart. When it comes to the knowledge of Allah, the guidance of the heart, is like that fertile land. It gives a lot of crops, a lot of plantation, and that will someone will be blessed. As Isa alayhi salam قال وجعلني مباركا. It is not for the purpose of every believer to be Mubarak. Is not to be blessed, blessed, protected by Allah, and walks with blessing, and will help other people are being alone and alive. That is the mission of the believer. That is the mission that we need to reclaim, that we need to reflect on, that we need to implement and renew it in this blessed Ramadan. We don't want the Ramadan to pass by just thinking of being inside the masjid, which is alhamdulillah a great thing, or waiting for the breaking of the fast to fulfill the desire of the stomach. Ramadan is something else. We, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a beautiful hadith that is very threatening for every one of us. He said, when he was saying Ameen, climbing the member three times, one of them, as we mentioned one time, they've been asked, he said, Jibreel came to me and I said, Ameen. And I said, Ameen for those who will witness Ramadan and will not be forgiven, that Allah will expel them from His Rahmah forever. And this is when we say, SubhanAllah, so this is an opportunity for us. Isn't an opportunity for us to reflect on the true mission? When we ask forgiveness, we know what we ask Him for. Therefore, when we say, Kal-Ghayth is like the rain, are we getting the Qur'an and the guidance from the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and from Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala to be like the fertile man? Or qala aw qala asabat ajadib. Ajadib are this type of land that they hoard the water but they don't plant. So that Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala make people to benefit from it by getting the water out of it. And our other qala, this type of lands like barren land, sterile land, they will not get the water or nor they will give any plants. And that's the people who are ungrateful. The people of their heart are dead. Everything, SubhanAllah, remember, it started with the purest of the heart, secluded in a cave. No one knows about him except Allah, the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To be sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mustaqar al-ish'a, to be mustaqar of the complete light, it is the recipient. Allah revealed on his heart the complete light. And he start to convey this message sallallahu alayhi wa sallam alone, to turn to be an ummah, that an ummah with characteristic that only exists in this ummah. Characteristics qa'imatun ala al-haq, standing for the truth. Characteristic that is wasfuha al-rahma, it being described by the rahma. It is characteristic, the third, is action, is justice. Standing on the truth, known by its rahmah, and acting only with justice, that is the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that's what we need to reflect on. Is Ramadan, are we follower of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this way? Therefore, let someone will ask, what the heart need to be to have this characteristic of the ummah that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam built? They have to have three things. Imanun wa sabrun wa jihad. Three things. If we want to be that light, because if you want to be like the ghaith, if you want to be blessed, that you protect yourself and spreading blessing around you, which is me that you're gonna be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you need to work to bring in your heart or to check in your heart if you already have them, to refresh them, to renew them, to revive them, which is in fact reviving the mission that we created for. It would ease, in fact, to dignify ourselves and bring back ourselves, that we are not simple consumer, that we are not people who need to their desire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the sun to work for you, and the sea to be subservient to you for you, and someone he's prostrating to his desire, or someone he's prostrating to toys or to his stomach. That is not the way of the believer, especially in this great month where he needs to revive the spirit of the iman. The three things that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us, and he called his ummah, and he built his ummah on, al-imanu wa sabr wa jihad. Al-imanu, the first thing is, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Sa'd, to Mu'adh ibn Jabal, al-imanu al-islamu ra'sul islam, ra'sul amr. It is the head of the all matter. And al-sabr, he said, dhiya, patience. It's like a glowing light, that's what it gives you, the light. What jihad, the striving, is the peak of everything. If you don't have that fervor, if you're not driven for the good, therefore we're dead. And these three aspects in the heart that someone needs to reflect in his Ramadan, to bring them back, to install them, if we can say, to revive them if we have them. Because it's either someone has weak iman or the iman is going down. And the iman going down or up, it depends on the light of the iman, how much you have from this light. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called it light. And this light not only runs in us, but when it runs in us, it gives the power of Allah for the universe. And what I'm telling you is from the Quran and Sunnah. وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِنْ أَمْرِنَا مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِمَانِ. And it's like this, that we revealed on you a soul from our command, alive, things that give us life for the heart and give life for the whole universe. مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابُ وَالْإِمَامُ. You didn't know before what the meaning of the scripture. You didn't know before what the meaning of the revelation. You didn't know before what the meaning of the Imam. But وَلَكِنْ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُورًا. But we made it as a light. We guide to it. هُمْ مُبِينُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. نَادِي بِهِ مَنْ نَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا. If someone will ask you, there's a shortcut in Ramadan to bring all this great meaning in the self, to have a very high head and strong heart, how someone should focus on. It is one thing if we can do it, but with a specific perspective. It is forgiveness. When we listen to forgiveness, we say something simple, but it's not about the forgiveness itself, it's about how do you think of the forgiveness? What do you think of the forgiveness? The forgiveness, dear brother or respected sisters, is not an end of a path. The forgiveness is the renewal of an oath. It's not an end of the path, oh Allah forgive me to take you to paradise. No. Oh Allah forgive me to have the element of light in my heart so can act to fulfill the mission I was created for. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Ali Imran describing believers fighting with the prophets. He said, and these people, when they are facing the enemy, they're asking for forgiveness. Are they asking for forgiveness to die? No, they're asking for forgiveness to refresh and renew the oath of Allah, to have the barakah from Allah, so Allah will give the help for them to have victory. وَمَا كَانَ قَوْلَهُمْ إِلَّا أَنْ قَالُوا رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا وَإِسْرَافَنَا فِي أَمْرِنَا وَثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَنَا وَانْصُرْنَا عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ. And Allah give us victory on those denial, all those our enemy. How He will give them victory, and they ask Him forgiveness before. So the forgiveness is not an end of a path. The forgiveness is a renewal of oath. So Allah will give them blessing to face their enemy. So when we ask forgiveness in Ramadan, it's not a forgiveness, just say Allah give us forgiveness and it is the end. The forgiveness, and you need no forgiveness to bring you a stronger iman. Forgiveness to bring you stronger patience. Forgiveness to make you driven and you have the right sense of the jihad. Striving to do good, striving to be just. And this is the meaning of the maghfirah. It turned to be enlightenment of the heart. It turned to be adding of the blessing. It turned to be a strong will to follow the footsteps of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That is the meaning of the forgiveness. Therefore, when we say the forgiveness, it is not the forgiveness to just to Allah forgive you to enter paradise. It's the forgiveness to add your iman so you can revive the mission of Islam in your life. It's the forgiveness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revive the cell of your iman in your heart, to be someone running for the maghfirah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's in the meaning of the forgiveness. And when you think of that, you say, subhanallah, it's not the best dua ever that is, will be commanded to us to do in Laylatul Qadr, is to ask Allah for forgiveness. Allahumma innaka afuun kareemun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anna. Therefore, when you say, afu anna ya Allah, is a renewal of oath to be a greater believer, to be stronger in your iman, to be someone who rush and race more for forgiveness and the paradise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and doing good. And what do you think? What will help us to rush for the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We only ask for two things. The first thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's secrets, how He's taking care of you without you knowing. Like in a narration, narration of the Nun al-Muslim. He said, one time I was laying down and I saw a river, by a river, there's this big giant frog. On top of it is a snake. It was very amazing scene. He stood and he wanted to follow. And he saw this frog crossing the river. And then when he got to the other shore, the snake moved. SubhanAllah. So it's like the frog was the means of transportation of the snake. And he was looking at the snake, and the snake is going towards someone who was laying down. And this person was drunk.
And next to this person, there is another snake about to bite its ear or his ear. And this snake that was riding over the frog came and hit the other snake and killed it. The Dun al-Masri came and he wake up this man. He told him, I'm going to tell you what happened to you. He said, now a snake was about to bite you and another snake came to kill you. He said, you are fully healed and Allah taking care of you. Even you are in a state of sin. The man, he fell in tears. He said, Ya Allah, this is your ihsan. This is your goodness with those who are sinning, who are committing sin, who are fighting you with their sin. What will be your ihsan for your believers? What will be for your ihsan for those who come to your masjid? What will be your ihsan for those who fast in Ramadan? What will be your ihsan for those who invoke you for your repentance? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to repent on us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ask to accept our forgiveness. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the right understanding of His deen. And reviving our heart the mission of Islam. And reviving our heart the iman. Patience and the striving in the sake of Allah. نقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا وغفر الله. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد. In this way of the forgiveness and its perspective that we are invited to think of. The forgiveness to renew our oath. A forgiveness to have back the barakah and the blessing in ourselves. A forgiveness to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us, as the Prophet said, like the rain, to make us like Isa alayhi salam, to be mubarakun. And this is something that there is a target of the believer, is an objective of the believer. A great example in the Sunnah, a great example in the Sahaba. Some of them, they were like, even the Prophet ﷺ ordered them to be even executed because of what they did against the Prophet and against the Islam and against the Muslim. One of them is Ikrimah ibn Abi Jahl. But when he came and repented, the Prophet ﷺ forgave him. And Ikrimah died in a state of shaheed. Khalid ibn Walid in Ma'akat al-Yarmouk, talking to Abi Amr, he told him, Ya Abu Amr, istabqina ala nafsik. Take care of yourself. You are like a man, old man, you have kids and everything. We are taking care of that. He told them, Ya Khalid, leave me alone. How many times I've been fighting the Prophet ﷺ. Now that Allah gave me the opportunity after the forgiveness, that He filled my heart with iman and patience and with striving, you want me to turn away? He said, no, by Allah, I will never run away and flee away from the Jannah. I will never run away and flee away from the Jannah. And we have one great man that is known in the history of Islam, Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad. Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad was a man that of characteristic of iman and devotion to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was in Arafah and holding on his beard for a whole time from Asr to Maghrib in tears. And then he looked at his friend, he said, do you know who the worst of the people? He told him, no. He told him, the one who look at these people and he think that Allah will not forgive them. The one who look at these people and we think that Allah will not forgive them. That when we look at each other, we should not think of our sin, but think of the perspective how to come Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the way of the forgiveness. Because his name himself, Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad, he was a burglar that he go into from house to house. And one day, when he was above in on the roof of a house, he heard someone reciting the Quran in Qiyamul Layl saying, أَلَمْ يَأْنِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَن تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَمَا نَزَلَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ. It is not a time for the believers to turn into devotion to Allah and to repent. And he said, it is time, Ya Allah, and I address to myself and to you, it is not time in Ramadan to bring back this great element of iman and light in our heart. And to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness and ask Him for emancipation from the hellfire. Allahumma khirna la dhunubana in Ramadan. Allahumma barik lana fi Ramadan. Allahumma taqaddar siyamana wa qiyamana wa du'ana. Allahumma innaka afuwwun kareem tuhibbu al'afwa fa'fu 'anna. Afina wa'fu 'anna. Allahumma ya arhamar rahimin. ويا أكرم الأكرمين، أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا ووفقنا لاجتنابه، آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم إنا نسألك خشيتك في الغيب والشهادة، ونسألك كلمة الحق في الغضب والرضا، ونسألك القصد في الفقر والغنى. اللهم يا أرحم الراحمين، نسألك لئيما لا يلخب وقرة عين لا تنقطع، ونسألك اللهم برد العيش بعد الموت. اللهم اجعلنا هداة مهتدين، وزينا بزينة الإيمان. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين، وآخر الصلاة يرحمكم الله.